Topical Finasteride and Minoxidil. You've probably heard of brands like Keeps, Hims, and Roman all selling topical finasteride products to treat hair loss. And many of the formulas are actually mixed with minoxidil, which promotes hair growth as well. In this video, we will talk about how it compares with the pill form of finasteride, its effectiveness in terms of bringing your hair back, and then talk about side effects, because as you know, the pill form of finasteride doesn't really have the best side effects. And in the end, we'll talk about the best way to use it. So definitely stay with me until then. Also, real quick, guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe if you like this type of content, and let's get started. Let's do a quick rundown on Hims first, which is the men's wellness marketplace. Their topical finasteride and minoxidil spray targets receding hairlines and bald spots at 0.3% finasteride and 6% minoxidil, which, as you can see, is their number one bestseller. So if you click get started, they walk you through the intake form, then a provider will take a look at it, and then you get discreet shipping straight to your door. With improvement, you can see it take about 3 to 6 months. Keeps is another popular one, but with 0.25% finasteride and 5% minoxidil, and claim results in 4 to 6 months. Let's talk about how the finasteride itself compares with the pill form though, and if they're even comparable. In this randomized control trial on the efficacy and safety of topical finasteride spray involving over 450 people, they were able to find that topical finasteride significantly improves hair count compared to placebo and is well tolerated. Its effect is similar to that of oral finasteride, but with markedly lower systemic exposure and less impact on serum DHT concentrations, which means less side effects with topical. The results mentioned that no serious adverse events were treatment related, and that maximum plasma finasteride concentrations were over 100 times lower than the pill form. Great for anyone who doesn't want the finasteride side effects, even though they aren't as common as you might think, like erectile dysfunction and lower libido. So then why add minoxidil? The study on topical minoxidil fortified with finasteride found that the penetration of topical finasteride is a matter of concern, right? Therefore, minoxidil being a vasodilator and a potassium channel opener was used in combination with finasteride to aid in better absorption. So it's to increase absorption. Plus, don't forget, minoxidil itself increases the size of the follicle. So it's kind of like a double whammy here. And you can watch my video on minoxidil here that actually goes into a lot more depth about it. So how effective is this combination spray? That's what we all want to know. Well, in the International Journal of Clinical Pharmacology and Therapeutics in 2014, they found that scalp DHT was reduced by 68 to 75% with topical finasteride treatment and 62 to 72% with oral finasteride for men with androgenetic alopecia. That's really promising to me, but here's what you got to know. If the hair loss is very long-standing, then it's less likely to be a significant number of viable hair follicles from which new hair can grow. The key word is number of viable hair follicles. How many do you have left? Let's say even if you have a visibly completely bald scalp, right? It could still have some peach fuzz, which means the follicles are still there, which is a good thing, but they are in a different stage of follicle miniaturization as vellus hairs. This is why the treatment will still work best if you start it early. But let's talk about side effects for a second here and real expectations with this product. While the topical finasteride form does not reduce blood DHT levels as much as the oral form, which is great because you reduce the chances of side effects and still get very similar results, males with a female partner that's pregnant or may become pregnant should not use topical finasteride as it can increase the harm to the fetus. Other common side effects are itchiness, irritation, and headaches, or even lightheadedness. And speaking about its use for women, the sister company to Hims called Hers also has a postmenopausal hair loss spray with finasteride and minoxidil as well. And even though topical finasteride doesn't have FDA approval, it's gaining popularity in postmenopausal women who take it for off-label for hair loss. But you'll need to speak with your doctor to see if it's right for you, because one, it's not to be used during pregnancy and breastfeeding, and two, finasteride can interfere with estrogen and testosterone balance depending on how much becomes systemic leading to a potential risk of estrogen-mediated malignant transformation. So those with a family history of breast cancer will want to look into other hair loss treatments that I've linked below as well. But all in all, with all the treatments for hair loss, it could take up to 6 months to see a noticeable improvement. So hang in there if you are on any of them. But I'm more curious to actually hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on topical finasteride and minoxidil? Let me know in the comments below. Also, hit the subscribe button if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.